Hello traders, Rich here, and here's a quick but detailed update on HOT. As usual, if you guys like video analysis, let me know in the comments or simply leave a like. So let's get started. As we clearly see, HOT has been overall bullish for a while, making higher lows and higher highs trading inside this brown channel. And when we are overall bullish, we'll be waiting for the correction to be about to end to catch what? The next impulse movement upward. Just like here previously, impulse, correction, we were looking for bus stops to catch the next impulse movement upward. And we'll do exact same thing around this area since price is now approaching the lower bound or non-horizontal support as we can see in brown. And I insist on the word looking for bus stops, because HOT can still break this zone downward, which is our support. In this case, a movement to our next demand zone in blue would be expected, where we'll be looking for new buy setups to form. But anyway, let's take it step by step, right? While overall bullish in a correction phase, approaching a support area while looking for buy setups. So if we zoom into H4 time frame, you can see that quite clearly in a correction phase, we've got this impulse, correction, and we are currently in this impulse movement, pushing price downward, and we don't want to buy a bearish market, right? So just like we did previously, we're waiting for the buyers to take over, and then we'll be looking for buy setups, right? So we are bearish trading inside this channel, and for those who already know me, I'll be waiting for a new swing to form around our upper red trend line to consider it valid and to consider it, as usual, our trigger swing. That's why I highlight it like this as our trigger. I don't know why it's in blue. I'll make it in green in a bit. Here we go. So let's make it in gray as usual. That's it. Okay, so waiting for this to happen, and in this case, we'll be buying HOT if and only if the conditions are met, as mentioned in this video. In this case, a movement till our upper resistance in brown would be expected, which would result in a new high to around 0.02. Meanwhile, and until this happens, HOT would be overall bearish from a medium-term perspective, and the bears can still remain in control by breaking below it, and a movement till our lower demand zone, as mentioned from daily, would be expected. That's it for HOT. Before we continue, I want to tell you about MUDREX. MUDREX is one of the world's leading algo trading platforms. It has more than 30K registered users from 90 different countries, with over 2 billion total traded volume on the platform. It's very simple. When you log into your account, you go to invest, algo, and you've got over 300 different strategies to choose from. And you can also filter it through these features: top score, popular, and so on. You can click on them on any algo and you check the expected return, number of investors, and so on. So you click on it and check all the details to decide if it suits your risk appetite, personality expectations, and so on. You can even build your own algo and monetize it to attract investors, but we'll talk about this in the next video. If you don't have an account yet, make sure to create one using the links in the description below to get $25 sign up bonus. And let's continue. As we clearly see, AUDCAD has been overall bearish for a while, making lower highs and lower lows. However, we can see that the bears are exhausted because they couldn't push price lower as they were pushing before. So we had this impulse, correction, and even bigger and steeper impulse. However, starting from here, the impulse movement pushing price downward are getting smaller in size and more flat, and the correction are getting steeper and bigger in size, which gives us an early alert that a potential reversal might happen. And it's currently trading inside this channel. We've got our upper bound acting as a non-horizontal resistance and the lower bound acting as a non-horizontal support. That's why we'll be looking for buy setups. Moreover, we have this horizontal support from daily and weekly timeframes. So it's very important to know where we stand in the market before zooming into lower timeframes to look for setups. In this particular case, since we are around a support area and around the lower band, which is the lower brown trend line, that's why we'll be looking for buy setups. And I insist on the word looking, because price can still trade lower, break the support and trade lower, or even trade lower, dive inside it before going upward. So always wait for extra confirmation and trigger that the buyers are finally taking over. From H4, we can also see we've got this impulse, correction, and so on, and the price is still making lower highs So we are still technically bearish from a medium term perspective. However, since we are around a support area, oops, let's go back to H4, and here's our support area. We will be looking for a potential bullish reversal. So, and for those who know me, I'll be waiting for this third swing. I can't really know where it would be. It's just a projection. I'm not predicting that this will happen, just a projection that this is what I would like to see, so that the trend line would be valid, and we'll consider this as usual as our trigger swing, and I highlight it as our trigger. And of course, if this happens, then the buyers would take over. And as usual, for the buy, for the stop loss, it would be below the previous low, and we target a 1-to-2 risk to reward ratio, which would be around the upper bound or the upper brown trend line, which is acting as a resistance area. And of course, we also got this horizontal resistance. Meanwhile, until this happens, AUDCAD would be overall bearish and can still trade inside this channel, break the zone downward, or even go flat here before forming a new bullish reversal setup. That's it for AUDCAD. Best of luck, and I'll see you on the next one.